This is Singapore. I'm not sure I can answer the question, can I?
I have no idea.
A hot woman.
Woman?
Yes. Absolutely.
Sex where they show everything?
Yeah. Can you say it again? Girls and guys doing sex.
Right.
Doing heavily, no? They kind of hardcore. It can be something to drink, something to eat, or name of a book.
Person who doesn't change, hardcore, you can't, yeah.
Very extreme. Yeah, into something. Who's very into it, who likes it a lot, who'll do anything for it. Yeah.
My name is Mohd Faizal.
My name is Waimi Subandi.
I'm Hadi. History of hardcore. The history of hardcore.
Started out somewhere in the early 90s, no, maybe 80s, I can't really remember.
The first band to start hardcore was my band, Stomping Ground.
Went to a gig where I saw a band called Stomping Ground.
Stomping Ground.
We were so congested with a lot of punk and death metal bands, I found this kind of music somewhere in New York. The music was very aggressive as the others, but the lyrics were positive.
Started to play this hardcore stuff is when I was 15. I had my first gig. I think I was forced into it. My friend Hisham, he asked me to play in a band, and I was like sort of dragged into it. And somehow or other, I questioned. I don't understand why people stop hitting me. I don't know why people do this, why people that. I say one thing leads to another. I buy Zine and understand thoroughly what they're trying to portray in their message, and just one thing leads to another. Play in a band, still uses music as a medium of to express themselves. Right now, I don't know, some I guess we just worn out, exhausted, and just sick of the violence in the scene. A bit too much violence and too little thinking.
Violence in music, it's more of what the artist has to say. So it depends on whoever writes the song and what they are trying to express it out.
I think each generation adds some kind of way to express their position on more or less violent way.
It has its side effects on the kind of music like they take on hard rock metal.
People just mimic, you see. People follow what they hear. I mean, you know, it gets into their consciousness such that, you know, knowingly or unknowingly, they act out what they listen to. I mean, likewise for movies. We don't want to say that movies cause violence directly. But we cannot not say that there is a correlation somewhat. So I think even for music, this is the same case.
They know how to comment. Last time when we started out, all the songs are like people say shouting. Nowadays, the same people who criticize us, they're doing it dead now. And I think it's a little bit outdated already.
We are in a society where it calls hardcore society, and we are totally different from a normal society. But we can accept their opinions, and we can see the difference between our opinion and their opinion. But what I see in this hardcore scene is like we can express ourselves and together we can share our belief.
The truth is, when I started this, I don't care about anything. Whether you like my music, whether you don't like, I don't care. Whatever I do, even today, whatever I do, I don't care what people say. Because in the end, you are the one who helped yourself, and nobody will help you.
Old people will be old people. Parents will be parents. They will be like concerned, and obviously they're trying to put a stop to it. Because they see it as something violent, unorthodox. Why is there people body surfing? They might get hurt. It's a release of emotion, it's a release of frustration. Everybody has this medium of how do you want to release hope or understand frustration, anger, emotion. Don't ban things that you don't like. That is something that the government like to do. What they don't like, they don't understand, they just try to put a stop to it.
Government, I don't think they are aware about us. I mean, I also don't care about them. I mean, not don't care about what they are. I mean, like, do they care about us?
None of this can be accepted. Maybe lyrically, it is so thought-provoking. Like, the music itself is so freaking noisy. It's just a counterculture. I just have to accept the fact that maybe one day we can cope with one another, but the thing is that older people be older people, there'll be this gap between us. And then unless we have this barrier broken down, we'll be living in a happy place now.
One of the flyers is about fast food chain. The other flyer is about it's on race, it's based on topic of racism. And I have to show you this.
Put a stop to what is wrong, like racism, fascism, neopolism, there's only zim out there. It's up basically up to the person. Maybe when someone sees a pamphlet and a leaflet or whatsoever, they can either read the headlines and just throw it away or just keep it to themselves to understand why are these idiots just giving up leaflets and stuff like that.